Презентацію книжки прибула чисельна кількість зацікавлених у дослідженні професора Пола Магочі. Модератором дискусії був професор Петро Галадзе.
A wonderful teaser for the book itself. I can promise you that if you start reading it, you won't be able to put it down. You know, because Bob Magucci is such a great writer, has a wonderful style, but also it's filled with facts that people will find very interesting. And if I might just add here, I think the publication of this book indicates two very important things. The maturity of our community, the ability to discuss these kinds of things openly, and also the fact that we're all getting really old because we're able to talk about this and not be too worried about things that happened in some cases 35 years ago.
Can one enter a period of Ukraine fatigue in the academic world? After all, we've been hearing that the stimulus, the motivation behind creating Ukrainian study centers, whether in the United States or Canada, came from people of Ukrainian background of various generations who had a personal commitment, but they were helped by one very important thing. Something that sustained them. And that was an enemy. There was no Ukraine. There was no independent state. Certainly when we grew up, as Frank knows very well, in the United States, which is much different from Canada, someone says something, they ask who you are, what this is Ukraine, oh, that's Russia. I mean, literally. Every normal American immediately would respond that Russia, what Ukraine? Well, that, comments just like that, stimulated people like Frank or people like Lubomir to, you know, I've had enough of this garbage. And so now I'm going to do something about it in whatever way that I can. Namely, it's statelessness that saves cultures, because it gives you a purpose to overcome the lack of knowledge in the environment in which you live. I guess, and people will not like this, and it's not meant to be flippant in any way, shape, or form, but the fact of the matter is, we know in Ukraine today, we know, if you study even superficially what has gone on in the last 4 years, we have to thank somebody for transforming the vast majority of citizens of Ukraine into Ukrainians, as citizens and patriots of that country. And we know who that person is up there in the north. It's really thanks to him that has kept something Ukrainian alive in people. And similarly, if we talk about potential Ukraine fatigue, like German fatigue or Italian fatigue or Spanish fatigue, if we're talking about studying these homelands in a serious way, we're saved for the moment, by an illegal occupation in the south of the country, and a war in the east of the country. So at least, you know, Ukraine is somewhere out there on the horizons, on the screens of the public at large. Unfortunately, it costs life in order for that to be the case. But, you know, what do we want? We're only humans. This is how we are.
Дискусію вели професор Роберт Остен, Ігор Бардин, професори Любомир Лоцюк та Франк Сисин.
The book presented to you, and for most of you, you received it at the door, so you haven't had an opportunity to do more than peruse it, is a book which I think is written with a certain verve, and at times showing certain anger and dissatisfaction. and is certainly written with full zealotry and feel for the subject, as only one can write about one's life. I think it is, we would like to think we can distance ourselves through time, but I don't think many of us can do it. And the events being described in a series of questions that are posed in this book, I think drew forth many of Bob Madhuchi's views, his feelings about events, and then he has always with his care of one, he's a wonderful archivist. He has kept probably better documentation than anyone else of his generation.